Most people might know about Pingu. It was a show about the main protagonist named Pingu, a clay pink penguin who goes on adventures with his friend or family. I have known most things about him ever since I was 5, but now, a 7th grader, I have new information about him. This is Amira Lamir, from South Korea writing this, and this is how I found a lost episode of my favorite nostalgic character. Back in December 2020, I went on my dad's computer to finish my math homework, all about circumferences, areas of a circle, stuff like that. After I've done my homework and submitted it to Google Classroom, I started to Google Pingu episodes that most people had forgotten, but I watched. Some include, Pingu refuses to help, Pingu, a very special wedding, etc. While Googling, I found a strange blog about Pingu. The blog title said in cap locks, 2020 Pygus Group Interview, Watch at Own Risk. I looked at the title strangely. Why did it say Watch at Own Risk? I had no choice but to click on it since I was a curious person. There was a video and a whole blog about it. I clicked on the video. From what I remember, the video was in a bit of a bad quality, like watching a VHS video, and the date on the bottom left corner was 1981. I put two and two together. It's not a new interview, and the person who wrote this may have mixed the dates or played a twisted joke. I continued. It was Otmar Goodman, having an interview. I was so excited, but something was wrong. He said in a disappointed tone that someone in his company has been charged with murder and, I think, animal cruelty. Before he was fired, he left a VHS tape written in blue Sharpie that said, Pingu Incidents. I was baffled and wondered what it was. But Otmar said something scary. Otmar said that the person not only made this VHS, but he made copies of the tapes by sneaking into a company that made VHS tapes during midnight, created one VHS for each 3 countries, and that he already dropped them off by using Swiss Post, some random coordinates, and a lot of packaging process. Now looking back, I didn't know if this was scary or not that dangerous. Otmar then said,
if you see or hear about the tape, please discard it by destroying, sending it, or informing the police immediately.
Then it ended with a fade of a black screen, then a blue background with a picture of the cassette, a phone number you can contact, and a message that said, if you see this cassette, please report to anyone or discard by destroying. I then look at the blog. It said that after the narrator heard about it, he was throwing out garbage and found it. But they burned it. It made a snake hiss, almost as if the cassette felt enraged when it was burned. The narrator said, I was in complete shock. What if I find that tape? Will I get arrested? Will Otmar or the Pygus group take it and keep it as a secret or discard it? I had a lot of thoughts circulating around my brain. Alright, Christmas has ended and I'm in my uncle's Turkish restaurant in Korea, drawing my Wings of Fire characters while near me, a cake from a Tusum place as a present for my dad. Then my dad walked near me and gave me 20,000 ones as a Christmas gift. I hugged him and gave him the funnel cake with chocolate. I told him I'm going to the antique store. He said he's fine with it as long as I don't buy something for 20,000 as a joke. I laughed while I dashed from the door. As I was running to the Korean pawn shop, I spotted a poster, so I translated it. It said, Goblin Pawn Shop Limited Time, buy a VCR, and get 5 free cassettes. January 20th to January 31st. I was excited and dashed there. There was an old woman who greeted me in Korean. I greeted her back in Korean. I asked her about the VCR. She said she had one and if I would like to buy it. I said yes politely. She said I could choose any VHS I wanted. So I picked Pingu, A Barrel of Fun, Berenstain Bears Learn About Strangers, Pingu, A Very Special Wedding, and Pingu, The Biggest Video Ever. I was fine until I saw the 5th one. I picked it up. The title was Pingu, An Accidental Purchase. The front showed Pingu looking at a receipt disappointed. Near him was a bag of red salmon, but on the bag there was a picture of a blue fish. On the back of the cassette, there was a caption on the VHS that said, 4 episodes. Pingu quarrels with his mother, Pingu's dangerous joke, Pingu refuses to help, and Pingu and the accident. I was surprised. I never heard of the 4th episode ever. I looked at the bottom corner. The date on it said it was made in 1981. I thought it was sketchy because the interview I saw last year said 2020. However, how could the episode suddenly sneak in like that? I thought of it as nothing and the cashier registered my VHS and my VCR. I was heading back to the restaurant until I saw my dad was waiting near the exit with my bag, my sketchbook, and happy eyes. When we got into the car, he asked me what did I buy. I said it was a VCR and some cassettes. My dad said jokingly that I am an antique lover. We both laughed. When we got home, my sisters were ready to go to dance class since my mom was taking them and my dad had to go to work. My mom told me I had to grab my PJs and put them into the washing machine. After all of my family left for work and dance classes, I did what my mom asked me to. Put my llama pajamas, which smelled of sweat, and grab a new pajama, which had dark green pants and a gray shirt with the Eiffel Tower on it and it said Paris in dark green and cursive. After this, I went on my phone and grabbed the Pingu, an accidental purchase cassette from the brown paper bag I bought it in and found out that no episode called Pingu and the accident existed, only giving you another episode of Pingu, Little Accidents. I had questions. Is this a new cassette or old cassette? Is this an unreleased episode? Is that really a new episode or a scam? I grabbed the brown paper bag with the VCR and the cassettes and after some connecting, I finally managed to connect the VCR to the old TV my dad got from his office while cleaning last week. I took out Pingu, an accidental purchase cassette and inserted it into the VCR and it worked. I was excited and sat down. After watching Pingu quarreling with his mom, Pingu learning a lesson that sometimes jokes can be dangerous, and Pingu learning that ignoring help is not cool, I finally got to the last episode, Pingu and the Accident. Before the episode started, there was a warning. Why would there be a warning? I was feeling suspicious. The warning screen was pitch black, a Pingu PNG was waving on the bottom of the screen, the word, warning, was red and it followed with a white Android serif message. It said, warning. This is an unreleased episode of Pingu dating June 23, 1990. This episode is released in the future because of its disappearance, hiding, and shipping for a very long time. Please take the tape from the VCR if sensitive. My chest pounded. What did it mean by sensitive? The screen would disappear after some seconds and the intro started. Everything was alright but the quality was looking as if there was a dust storm in the show. The setting was outside the main protagonist's house. Pingu was getting ready for school, mother was getting Pingu ready for kindergarten, and father went to work at his post office. As Pingu ran out the door, he saw Robbie, his seal friend. Then they both went to school together. There was a mild static that should not belong in a Pingu show. Then they both were in the school. Robbie went into a hole of water in it to hide from his classmates because he was new to them. Pingu's classmates then greeted Pingu. Pingu then introduced Robbie. He made the classic Newt Newt, and Robbie came out of the hole. His classmates were amused, even the schoolmaster. The schoolmaster got out a newspaper from his desk, smiling and announced in Penguinese that a free tour of a whale sculpture takes place near his neighbor's house, showing the picture. The whole class was abuzz and wanted to go, so they left early and went back to their homes with permission. Mild static again, and Pingu was packing his bag with a water bottle, a blue fish, and a camera. His mother was saying goodbye near the door, as Pingu was leaving and going back to the school, his mother was reading one of his comics, giggling. Static happened, and the whole class was walking near the teacher to the gigantic whale sculpture. The whole class awed, the schoolmaster was proud. Suddenly, the tail of the huge whale sculpture suddenly cracked. Under the tail, unfortunately, was a penguin with an exaggeratingly long mustache, a top hat and a bow tie explaining to the tourists about the statue. The tourists noticed the falling tail, even the class. They both screamed and warned the penguin about the whale's tail. He then yelled at them to stop. Unfortunately, it landed on the rich penguin, crushing him. Before he was crushed, I closed my eyes. Then I opened them. I heard a muffled scream that lasted for a second, sounds of broken bones, and screams of the tourists running and crying. One passed out and one called the sculptor. I paused the whole episode. It was gruesome. But what was more gruesome was that it wasn't clay blood, leaking under the whale tail. Realistically, it was either food coloring, animal blood, or human. There was static. It showed a black and white video of a person near a cliff of penguins. They all looked terrified and scared. Then the scientist would push off a full-grown king penguin off the cliff, make it roll, fracture its bones and skull and land onto the shore. Dead. After this it began to show a video of the same thing, but a walrus was in it, being pushed by a dominant male. When it landed on the shore, its eyeball was poking out and its tusk was hemorrhaged. It laid there. Dead. After 5 seconds, the scene changed to Pingu's house, now colorful. Pingu's family was quietly having dinner, not talking after the funeral. Then it shifted to the rich penguin's house. The wife of the rich penguin was sobbing on a stool. The voice didn't sound like pretend crying. It was as if the voice actor was in physical pain. She then scurried to a desk. She gripped a pencil on the desk and started to write on the notepad, surprisingly English.
I can't take it. Without my husband I am nothing. We wanted to make a family, something I wanted. I was once a cheerful individual some may know today. But now with him dead, I am nothing but a skin of myself. Goodbye everyone in the South Pole for traumatizing you and doing this, but I just can't take it anymore. If you see this letter, then I'm already deceased. Signed, Miss Pengold.
After a long silence that lasted like a minute, she grabbed her stool and unscrewed her chandelier, settling it onto the floor, exposing a hook, perfect for a rope. She grabbed the rope from the closet, and put it instead of the chandelier. She tied a noose and put it around her neck. She sighed and kicked the stool behind her. I closed my eyes. I had enough. I heard a gasp, the stool hitting the floor, and Miss Pengold was hanging. I only opened my eyes an inch when I saw her body hanging. I paused it to go to the bathroom and breathe heavily from the cursed things I had seen. Why did I take that cassette without doing more research about it? After that panic attack I had, I decided to watch the end. It had the same outro, but then it faded to a black screen. There was text saying, "This episode was told by me not to play it." Well, unfortunate soul, Pingu has already ended. Have fun with your life. Goodbye. Then a thought occurred for me to look at the cassette. I grabbed the cassette quickly and looked at it. It was skeptical because that VHS had a hand yield sticker. I ripped it off. I was shaking and crying. It had the same title as Pingu Incidents. I was shaking and I needed information about this episode. I contacted one of the sculptors, curators, of the Pygus group via mail and then on Zoom, pretending it was an interview, asking about basic stuff such as materials for Pingu, how animations are made and stuff like that. Finally, I couldn't hold it in, and said, "Have you heard of an episode called Pingu and the Accident?" The sculptor looked at me, lip quivering and eyes big as if they were carved out with a spoon. She sighed and told me the thing I'd like to call an urban legend come true. When Otmar Gutman and Carlo Bonomi were alive, there was an animator named Cecil Lopez. He was a confident man with a heart for everyone. Sometime during season 2, Cecil's brother, Mike Lopez, was having a phone call under a roofed bench. But one of the roof screws came off, causing the whole roof to topple over Mike. Cecil's brother was alive for the whole day he was in the hospital until he died due to a broken neck. After Cecil heard about the news, he was shaking and crying, knees on the floor. 3 days after the funeral, Cecil turned from a loud, confident, and heart for everyone employee to a quiet, non-social, egoistical, and threatening animator. He began to sculpt creatures and then strangling or squishing them, which isn't normal for him, watching different animals being squished to death by a hydraulic presser on shock scythes. He even threatened Carrie, herself, to kill herself because she threw away his documents, containing his love for death. After Cecil found out that Pingu was closing production by season 4, he was so enraged, he packed all of his things out of his desk by slamming them into a box and leaving the studio. He then was spotted by Carrie, snucking out of his home at 3 midnight, and after some time and effort, he made 15 cassettes of his animation in total. After he left, 2 days later there was a police report of Cecil, who was charged for animal cruelty and manslaughter. When he was put in jail, he escaped. He left a note, saying he is moving from Switzerland to the South Pole by private plane, where he would make a school called South Pole Public School. The creepiest thing is that no records showed he had a private plane nor made a school. He was last spotted in Zurich Airport, leaving the south gates and then spotted in the cockpit by some witnesses. Then the plane started to move and Cecil flew away, leaving a destruction of machines behind. After 2 hours he left, there was a reported plane crash near the shore of a beach. After rescue helicopters arrived, they found his remains and a note in fast writing, saying, "If you see this note, I may be in my destination or dead." I was shocked and I had no words to say. I said I will give the tape for them to destroy or keep. Perry said they might keep it in memory of him. I packed up the VHS, while she was on Zoom, I showed her the cover of the VHS, Pingu, an accidental purchase. Her eyes went big. She said that the cassette cover was the same cover for the other cassettes he released. I said, "What are we going to do?" Perry said,
"The only way to perish these cassettes out of this world is to warn the others.